Hey folks, welcome back. Chris Garlock here with Michael Redmond, 9-Don Professional, for our latest AlphaGo versus the World game. This is one of this 60 game commentaries that we're doing. We're working on volume 2 of AlphaGo 2-0. So in the meantime, you get to have a bunch of cool videos to check out. We're doing just focusing on the main points. And today we have a familiar name, Michael.
Yeah, it's kind of a special game for me. We have finally a Japanese player, Iyama Yuta. He was probably the only Japanese player who was high enough in the world ranking, like in the world ranking counting systems. They, most of the Japanese players were not doing well enough in international tournaments. So.
Right.
He was the one player who had a pretty high ranking there. And he played this one game, so it's special for that. And it's special in the fact, obviously, he is... one of the top players in Japan. He's one of the first players. He was the first player to have all seven of the big tournaments at the same time.
Not bad, right?
International tournaments was because he was really busy at home.
that's a hell of a schedule to have that many titles.
Oh, he's playing a lot of games, even now. Yeah. Sort of on top of the Japanese Go world. And it's also special because we're going to get a click-off.
Oh my goodness.
But not quite as effective as the last one. You remember we had a click on an earlier game,
I think it was game 10,
where the winning percentage for AlphaGo went from the 90% area to something like 65%. So it wasn't as if the human player had a chance to win, but it did make the game suddenly very close. It won't be that effective in this game, but I'll show you the click on here.
Let's see how Yama does.
So Yama has white, and they're playing 3-4 points again. It seems that in this stage of the set of games, somehow Master has switched to playing 3-4 points. It stopped playing 4-4 points. And Black plays a Kakari. So this is an opening that has been popular for a long time. And this is a case where actually White's Kosumi here, the diagonal move, was being played already. It's a shape that people would play already because Black does have these stones in the adjacent corners. It makes sense for White to be trying to keep this position in the upper left relatively simple. So this was already the standard move for humans, and it still would be considered a good move by computer programs. Black plays a shimari here. You can see Black AlphaGo is playing his favorite shimari and extends here. Very close to openings that have been played by human players. White plays a pincer. Now, this is a perfectly normal move, but this is a position where just about everyone knows now that the suggested move will be pressing on the fifth line. So that's
absolutely
here.
Absolutely right.
And something like this. And it turns out, after all, White's going to play this move. So you probably know by now that this is one of my favorite moves.
Yeah.
Because every chance I get, I'm going to mention it. But we just didn't know this move at the time because, I guess, because AlphaGo had not really shown it to us. There was actually one game in the series so far where it played this move, but there was some context. It was a position where there were stones in the area, and maybe people were feeling it was a kind of a special move for that particular board position. But you know, now people know that computer programs will suggest something like this in just about any board position. It's an effective way to take control of the side, in this case, the right side of the board, by giving Black some extra corner territory. And I really like this way of playing for White. In the game, White played a pincer here, and Black kicks in the corner. So this is where it gets a bit exciting. When Black kicks now and covers. And this is going to be a very sharp local fight here. And it's a bit dangerous for White. In fact, I think pretty soon at this point in the game already, it's giving Black, Katago is giving Black 58% winning percentage.
Mm-hmm.
That's close to 10 points on the board. And so that's a pretty... It's about 5% more than Black started with. And so a suggestion for White is to to play here and play these forcing moves and then play here, which is just making it that much more difficult for Black to break out into the center. Black can cut here, and something like this might continue. And so basically, if Black plays something like this, White is just going to avoid the fight in this case. Hmm. If Black cuts here, in this case, White can extend here. And White does have a fairly strong position on the left side. White does have that slide at the point where I've marked A, at the point E2, where White can slide it at that point and make trouble for the Black corner. It's not going to die, but it's going to be squeezed a bit. So this is a much better fight for White to be getting into when we compare it to the game. Just to take another look at the game variation, when Black covers here, Black already has a living shape in the corner. So it's that much better than this shape I was showing you here, where Black was not 100% alive. Well, it's more clear to say that maybe, although Black is alive, White's going to be able to push it around in this case. Whereas in the game, Black just has a very solid territory here and can still cut here. And when this does happen, White's position on the left side is going to have a little bit more trouble making eyes than that variation that I was showing you. So White plays down. White has to do something about these stones on the lower side. So White plays down, plays a hane here. This all makes sense, actually. It's a reasonable sequence for White here. But White's mistake came after Black cut here. So White plays this shape move, the one space jump. And probably the assumption that Black was going to play something like this, and White could play maybe something like this and get a base on the left side. It turns out that bumping against White here and then playing the hane, just because this atari is always going to be forcing, it was a much more forceful move than probably Iyama thought. It's a kind of a blind spot. Bumping against White like this, it's supposed to be a bad shape. Black is bumping against into Damezmari. White's two stones here. Let's mark the white stones instead. These two stones are hitting vital points. Cutting at the head of two stones is usually it's a very important vital point. So as far as shape is concerned, this is not so good for Black. But the fact that White is in such a cramped position on the left makes it very difficult for White to take advantage of that. So just to go back to this point, this is where White should have just, it's a bit vulgar, but White should just press here. And White can actually break out into the center because Black is short of liberties. White can break out like this. And if White does get to move out with these stones next, at some later point in the game, like something like this could happen, then White will have two Black groups to fight with. This Black group and this Black group, they're both not settled yet. White's group on the left here, if White plays this point, White will have a living shape. And otherwise, White is sort of halfway, White is poking his head out towards this direction. So if White plays somewhere there, he's going to be able to connect up to the corner.
Well, it looks a hell of a lot better than the game. I mean, White's shape is just scrunched down horribly.
Well, yeah. In this variation, White has potential counterplay, you might say. White has potential to counterattack. White plays this shape move and probably just overlooked this move that Black played. You have to remember that it is it's a lightning game. It's probably something like, I think it was 30 seconds per move. The players are making split-second judgments sometimes. So that could be part of it. And just the fact that the jump here is the good shape move that White played. The jump here is the good shape move. And what turns out to be the correct move, this one, was a bit vulgar. And the way Black took advantage of White's jump was also bumping against White's stone like that. Is a pretty vulgar move for Black, but very effective in this case.
Yeah.
And White plays the double hane here. This is another point where maybe White should have played here, in which case Black will just jump here. And it's this less pressure on the White group on the left. White does have, for instance, White can always, at any point play this exchange in the corner? So you see that if white plays this point, white has an extra eye there that white can make at any point. So it's the pressure on white on the left side is less in this case. And this stone here, the cutting stone here, which is turned into a group of two stones, it has more, it's more active than it was in the game. So in the game, white played this way, black cuts, and already at this point, black is something like 70%. So it's already pretty hopeless for white. Like white continued, let's just show you how it continued for a bit.
Yeah, I want to see the click.
Actually, yeah, this is worth looking at. White gets this fantastic squeeze, and it didn't help him at all. Like this is, why don't we just admire what AlphaGo did for a while here? There's no way for white to capture these stones, unfortunately. Like if white directly plays like this, black will be able to break through with this move. And so it's not quite working for white.
Wow.
Yuma found this beautiful squeeze by pushing here. White is continually threatening to wedge here and capture the two black stones. And so black pushes through. This is all forced. And now white cuts. And look at this beautiful squeeze. You'd think it's good for white, wouldn't you?
This
blob of black stones. Actually, I wasn't really so surprised by this 3-3 point. It's a pretty normal thing to do when white has a large structure like this. So this was okay. And so this happened. And black finally, look at that blob of black stones. It's supposed to be bad for black. And then black plays this weird move that is not a peep. It's not a cut. It's not a peep. It's just somewhere on the side. And it's not even alive. Black's going to sacrifice it. And black is taking stones from a living group. But it's all very effective, actually. So at this point, black has this huge lead. And we're getting close to the point where the operator is going to play a click-all. So I'll go into more detail. Actually, this was a great move later. And now, I think the move that AlphaGo wanted to play was this one. And black is going to get this nice area on the right side of the board.
Yeah.
And I don't know what happened. Maybe the operator was starting from somewhere around here and trying to go there or something like that. But there's this move. And this is a move that I would never think of playing.
Yeah.
And it was apparently a click-all. It was he brought the stone by mistake. And there was a game that Mentimling played where AlphaGo's winning percentage went from something above 90% to something around 60%, in the 60%. But unfortunately for Iyama, in this case, it didn't move so much. It turns out that this move that was played completely by accident was a pretty good move, and it reinforces black's territory in the corner. It's going to make it very difficult for white to reduce that territory, whereas normally white would have various moves, like white would have this move or the attachment of the 3-3 point, could still potentially make some trouble there. So a minor trouble, but there would be something there for white. So this move actually, it functions to a certain degree, and black still has this huge lead. So it was a game where there was a click-all played, but Iyama was sort of unfortunate with the fact that it turned out to be a fairly good move.
Oh man, even when you make it have a click-all, still wins.
It has to be a more effective click-all for the game to be turned around.
I see. All right, we'll work on that.
In the series, it never happened.
Okay, well, that was fun. The sequence too in the middle. I can't wait to see the announcement on that. Great, good stuff, Michael. As always, thank you. Thanks to everybody for watching. We'll see you next time.